I'm going to tell you how I set up VS Code on my phone and started programming a website. You can actually do this on any device, and you can pull in GitHub and start programming right away. I've actually set this up on multiple devices, including my Android and my iPad, and I'm going to tell you exactly how to do this in today's video. Let's check out how I did this. Traditionally, VS Code only works on desktops. Things like PCs and Macs, and maybe also Linux. In the first part of this video, we'll answer a simple question. How does this even work? Then I'll take you through the setup, which is easy and doesn't take long, I promise. And we'll be able to jump right in and have a lot of fun with it. VS Code is built on top of Electron, which is built on top of the Chromium engine. This is very versatile, allowing it to work on any operating system, whether it's Linux or Mac or even Windows. And yet, if you jump onto any mobile device, whether it's a phone or a tablet, and you jump onto the App Store, you won't find it there. And this is because Electron is only a desktop framework, and it doesn't work on mobile devices. And this is why we have to take a different approach to be able to get this to work. There are some great solutions out there already, which are very easy to set up. Things like remote desktop, where you could set up maybe TeamViewer, and even GitHub is trying to create a new solution on its own called Code Spaces, which will also allow you to work remotely in your own GitHub repository without any code editor, which will be really cool to look forward to. But these aren't the reasons that you're here, so let's have a look at how we can do this. Before we get started, make sure you guys hit like and subscribe. I want to destroy that like variable, and I can only do that with your support. Like most things, we'll start by opening up Google. Here we'll type in code server. And we're gonna look for the version here that exists in GitHub. Code Server is made by coder.com. This is a company that works on software development in the cloud. We're going to be using their open source package here to get VS Code up and running in just two lines of code. The first line is to actually install the script. So we're gonna copy this and paste it into a terminal. I'm just gonna load this through VS Code. Once this is done, it'll install all the dependencies. And our second step is to simply type in code-server. This will run up a local web development server of VS Code, which we can access in the browser. We're going to open up Chrome to be able to do this, and we're going to access our local IP, which is 127.0.0.1 on port 8080. Here we've got VS Code running in the browser, which is really cool. We've got a local project up and running, and we can see that we can immediately access the files and edit them as well. Great, but we haven't done anything special yet, because we've just loaded up VS Code like we would normally on a desktop. Let's take a look at how we can get this to work remotely outside of our computer. We're going to first have to change the configuration file, which is located here in config.yaml. Here, we're going to need to pull in our IP address in our local Wi-Fi network. For me, I'm going to pull this up by running ifconfig and pulling out this address, which is 192.168.101.178. I'm going to put this here and restart the server. This will run the web server for VS Code up on this new IP address, and that way I'll be able to access it on my mobile phone. Let's try that out now. I'm going to open up Chrome on my phone, which is part of my Wi-Fi, and access this IP address on port 8080. And VS Code is running, which is great. Okay, so we're halfway there. We can access VS Code on our computer and our phone via the Wi-Fi network, but the next step is to be able to access it over the internet. To be able to do this, we're going to have to increase the security a little bit. We don't want anyone to access our private VS Code simply because they know our IP address. So what we'll do is set a password in the configuration file by setting auth to password and making up a password to utilize. We'll also restart the service so this takes effect. We're almost there. We just need to do some port forwarding so that any traffic going from the internet goes straight to our laptop. I'm going to do this directly on my router by making sure that the ports are forwarded. And we're going to do this to forward to the IP address we set in earlier. This ensures that any traffic on port 8080 goes directly to my laptop. Great, the moment of truth. Let's jump into Google here and grab our online IP address by simply typing in my IP. Then we're going to type this here into the iPad. So I'm just going to put this in as 255.255.255.255. By putting the IP address in, I get prompted for a password, which I promptly put in. Then we're going to click submit, and we'll be right in our instance of VS Code in the cloud. Now, this is great. I'm accessing my computer remotely through the internet this time. We can even edit the text directly in this file. So I'm just going to type out maybe something like hello world to see if that comes through, and it looks like it has, which is great. There is something you should be aware of. It's the fact that none of this is actually working over SSL, which means it's not encrypted. So make sure that if you do want to do some sensitive work on here, that you generate an SSL certificate through things like Let's Encrypt. So let's take a look at some of the things we can now do using VS Code through the cloud on a browser on a phone. We can open up our files and folders straight from our computer. So in this case, I can browse into any directory. I can go back directories all the way back to the root directory, or I can browse into my GitHub folders and select a project that I usually utilize. From there, I'll be able to open it up. So in this case, I'll just open up the source folder with some files in there. I'll be able to access these files here on the left side and select one to start editing immediately. So this is pretty cool. So far, so good. And the next thing I want to do here is maybe have a look at some of the syntax and maybe add some lines of code. We don't have that much space to utilize here when we're in the code editor because the phone is a pretty small screen. And if we were to try this in landscape, we would find that we also have those issues. The next thing you can do is obviously install extensions. Now, all extensions are not available, only some of the major ones. So I'm going to try and download the dark theme for the actual Visual Studio Code here. But unfortunately, that just doesn't work. But that's okay. There are other extensions which I might like to try out. Things like maybe the React extension. That is always a good one that I utilize, especially for a lot of the React Native stuff I do. So we'll find that if I try to install that extension, it does work, which is great. And if you're out and about and you need to make some code changes, you can do this too by accessing GitHub code and committing those changes. Personally though, I like using this on my iPad because I usually take that with me on my lunch breaks. And sometimes I like to do a bit of coding while I'm having lunch over an hour. It is a little bit unfortunate that this setup only works if you've got a Mac or a Linux, and it's pre-configured to be able to access remotely. But there are solutions out there that allow you to do this without a Mac. For example, if you jump onto the Coder website, I can see that you can configure a workspace, which you can then access remotely with VS Code, similar to how I showed you just now. And Code Server also working on a beta, which does TLS, port forwarding, and even sets up a small domain name for you to be able to use. Let's actually check that out right now. What's amazing about this is that it's also a single line of code that does everything for you. So in this case, we're just going to pass in codeserver --link, and this will run up the new instance running with TLS authentication and port forwarding. This will be run up through the code server systems with a private domain name that you'll be able to use to access it at any time, and that won't change either. So that way you don't have to worry about your IP address changing because the dynamic DNS will just automatically update. Of course, I understand that not everyone will have the money to be able to purchase a laptop or a workspace from coder.com, and there are alternative solutions out there as well. I personally would recommend jumping on the Google or Amazon platforms. They have completely free tiers where you'll be able to access a virtual machine with 1 gig of CPU and RAM. And on there, you can set up Code Server and start deploying it on your phone to access remotely and start coding. This is a great free way to be able to get into coding if you don't have a laptop or a tablet and you just want to get started. This was a really fun video to do, so I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you hit like and subscribe. Otherwise, I'll see you in the next one. Thank you.